This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Prime. In association with Micromax. Nothing like anything.
Does form follow function?
And is great design just a function of utility?
Can the fusion of steel, glass and stone form the genesis of a masterpiece?
Can art and architecture go hand in hand in a world that's bursting at the seams?
It's a simple question, but is it as simple as it seems? Welcome to GROHA NDTV Design and Architecture Awards 2015, powered by EPCO. I'm Vasudha Sharma.
I'm Vikram Thapa, and I have designs on Vasudha's jaw.
Why is that, Vikram? I mean, I thought you had the coolest job on the planet. I mean, breakfast with Shah Rukh Khan, lunch with Deepika Padukone, and dinner and cocktails with Piggy Jobs.
Well, Vasudha, it is a really, really, you know, it's a difficult job, I know. Because last night I stayed up all night, you know, working really hard, watching TV.
Really? What were you watching?
I was watching Quantico on TV because I need to give Priyanka Chopra, you know, a lot of feedback on how she's doing. So I was up all night.
Oh my God, Vikram, your dedication to your job leaves me speechless. But you were saying something about wanting my job. Why is that?
See, you're the real estate anchor, you know, and correspondent for NDTV. You've obviously got access to some real, real, real great and prime property.
Okay, Vikram, let me break it to you that unlike the real thing, there's only one property, and that's the property show that I work for. And unlike the real deal, this doesn't grow at 15% per annum.
There's no truth to the rumor that you own 3 sea-facing flats at Nariman Point.
Even less true than the rumor that you're India's number one TV host.
Vasudha, I gave up coffee with Ranveer Singh, who was having coffee with Karan, who was having coffee with someone else, to be here. So you can just be nice to me for a change.
Okay, Vikram, I was just kidding, but I'm not kidding when I say that this is the only event that matters in the field of design and architecture, and this is the night.
Style, art and some really intelligent design, that's what we have in store for you guys tonight at the GROHA NDTV Design and Architecture Awards 2015, powered by EPCO.
We're coming to you today from the lovely Taj West End Hotel in Bengaluru, and it's only fitting that an award show related to property is hosted out of such a beautiful and iconic property.
Vasudha, we too have a beautiful property amongst us, and I'm not talking about myself.
Really? I thought you were.
No, I refer, of course, to NDTV's executive editor, real estate and business, Manisha Natarajan.
Good evening, everybody. A big round of applause to these young anchors who are trying to liven up the evening. And we would all like you to enjoy this thoroughly. And of course, meanwhile, I have a question to ask you, Vikram. Why are you being so nice to me? I do not do your appraisals.
But that's exactly what they told me. They said she's going to do your appraisals, and you can, you know, you're not an entertainment anchor anymore. You need to do like this real estate thing. I don't know what is happening.
All right. Okay. So bad news. I'm not doing your appraisal, but your boss does sit next to me in the Delhi office, so I will make sure you do a good job today and you will get a good raise. Ladies and gentlemen, let's get back to the serious business of bringing you this fantastic evening and, of course, bring you back to the awards.
Absolutely. Like last time, we have a great lineup of awards this year, which includes some truly inspiring proposals and nominations across 22 different categories.
And of course, an expert jury panel is a must of if one wants the right awards to go to the right people, which of course automatically rules me out. Anyway, some very smart men and women got together a few weeks ago to decide who all these awards should go to. Take a look.
Here are the rules. What can be done with one substance must never be done with another. No two materials are alike. No two sites on earth are alike.
The purpose, the site, the material determine the shape. Nothing can be reasonable or beautiful unless it's made by one central idea. And the idea sets every detail. A building is alive like a man. Chapter 1, page 24. The Fountainhead by Ayn Rand. The quote sums up the DNA of a winning architect and the mission of the Groha NDTV Design and Architecture Awards 2015, powered by EPCO, to find this DNA amongst the 1400 plus entries. India's top architects came together at Hyatt Regency New Delhi to cull out the top projects.
I think one thing is really that it goes across to the entire country and we get to see projects from all over the country, and then it's really good to kind of go through them and see what's the best out there.
I think for the architectural categories, I think we were looking for projects that had integrity, projects that were very clear and concise about their idea and their concept, projects that weren't too busy, but also satisfied all the functional requirements, but of course also were attractive.
Well, we are looking for what is today relevant for us, so that means in terms of energy, in terms of social meaning and content.
At the top of the jury's mind was also sustainability in design and its sync with the surroundings.
You kept it simple and you integrated the inside and the outside well, and the use of materials was very honestly expressed.
I think what stands out is when architects try to redefine lifestyles through architecture. So if you have a certain kind of climate that allows you to actually sit out in the open, to be able to provide that kind of space confidently and actually kind of make it work, that is something that is being done increasingly and with greater and greater sophistication, so that stands out.
I have to stress on the ecologically friendly design part of it. Whatever we do today is about the environment and keeping it green and sustainable.
Actually, I was surprised that there were a number of very fine offices projects, not necessarily maybe the urban projects, but some campus type entries, which are not necessarily in the cities. So there were a number of very fine office projects. Having doing a lot of work here in India myself, I was quite impressed with those categories.
The sheer size of the number of people who've entered is really quite remarkable. What would be interesting is to try and see if one can even go wider and penetrate perhaps into entries from even smaller towns, because I think there's a lot of interesting work that is happening in smaller towns with lower budgets.
Eminent jury, rigorous scrutiny, heated debates and warm discussions all went hand in hand to find the winning projects for the Groha NDTV Design and Architecture Awards 2015, powered by EPCO.
And now, of course, to introduce our knowledge partners for this year's award, Morphogenesis, the company that is known for its tireless advocation of sustainability. Ladies and gentlemen, put up your hands for Manit Rastogi, founder partner. So Manit, I don't know whether it was because it was our third year Viva Karma, but clearly it seemed that it was much easier doing it with you.
No, it wasn't easy.
No.
No, it was not easy. It wasn't easy with the fact that we didn't realize how many entries are going to come in. It wasn't easy because, you know, when we were trying to set the categories, we thought that it would be important to reinforce the notion of what really is the ethos of Indian design or has been. So we formed a new category of environmental for the climatic zones. We decided to also look at houses in the split categories of the five climatic zones of India. And there were many queries. Some were very interesting, but some was also sort of pointing out to the real crux of the problem. People were asking us that I am from this city, is this a composite climate or is it a temperate climate? And you see, you know, you don't know what climate that you know. And that is what we were really trying to get to. Mm-hmm. The power of the awards was the fact that it obviously being the only real award which has a media channel, TV, which penetrates tier 2, tier 3, tier 4, goes all the way. And I think the message, to try and get the right message through, was a really, really challenging task. But it was the most exciting as well.
Was it exciting for you? So what was the final message that you wanted to get to all the participants and even the audience here? I mean, I think 80% of them are architects, young, seasoned, eminent.
Can all the young architects please stand up? No. Right. Okay.
The front row is all standing up. I can see the youngest lot there. Mr. Jay.
There we go, Jatin. David, please.
Everybody. Very young lot.
There we go. Thank you. No, I think the message really is that, and I think, you know, we're at a very interesting time. You know, we've got 400 schools of architecture. We've got about 100,000 students of architecture in this country. And the number of registered architects are about 50,000, you know. Mm-hmm. And in a span of 3 to 4 years, we'll probably be getting more architects out of our institutions than exists registered in the country. Now the question is teaching, ethos, vision, philosophy, you know, are these things that are that can be ingrained? And I think it is the responsibility of media and awards to make sure that what really makes us Indian, what really makes us belong to a place, or at least nearly belong to a place, should be reinforced. And I think that is the biggest message that we can get out there.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Every once in a while, someone comes along and completely changes the landscape of design and architecture. So it's only fitting that that someone is recognized with an award for Landscape Design of the Year.
And to announce the winner, I would like to call on stage eminent architect Dean De Cruz and Sanjay Kothari. Let's have the nominees, please.
Threefold Design for Twin Pavilion for Axel Partners. Urban Initiatives for Redevelopment of Gopi Talao As Lake, Surat. Sunil Patel and Associates for VVIP Circuit House 1. Rajendran Associates for Botanical Gardens. OSB for Bird Heaven.
And the winner is, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Rajendran Associates.
The important thing about this project is, it's very easy to do private projects, but this is a public project and it was won through international competition. And this was conceived as a work of art, freed from the conventional constraints, spurred by the prime location. It is in the heart of Chennai, and I'm sure this is going to be a role model and encouraging thing for the rest of it. My sincere thanks to NDTV, the eminent juries and the sponsors.
We have a special jury commendation in this category, landscape design category, and that goes to Urban Initiatives.
We did this project. The project that we have been given the commendation for is a public park which was kind of rejuvenated from non-existence, and I'm happy that after 15 years of work we have been able to give it back to the city of Surat. And thank you very much NDTV for kind of appreciating this. Thank you very much.
Architecture isn't just about bold lines and gas-inducing design. High quality infrastructure is essential to urban living and is often the unsung hero all our lives. And so it's only fitting that our next award should recognize its importance. To hand out the award, I'd like to call on stage Mr. Deepak Sabru, Vice President, Sleek International Private Limited.
Let's have the nominees for the Infrastructure Architecture Award of the Year.
Sikka Associates for NSCBI Airport. Arcon Consults for Vadodara Barok Toll Plaza.
And for this category, we're giving out a special jury commendation, and that goes to Arcon Consults.
I would like to thank to NDTV and the sponsors of the event, and humbly accept the award on behalf of the all the team members of ARCOM and the man behind the show, Saurabh Gupta. Idea behind was to make a canopy-less toll plaza. These are all canopies you show, you see, are retractable canopies, which kind of shade only the toll giver, and the rest of the queue is out in the sun or the rain. So it can be folded back, and it can be used only in terms in times when you need it.
Intelligent design is all about creating structures that work with the environment that they're intended for. And in a country with climates as varied as India's, that skill is put to test like no other in any part of the world.
And to announce the winner of this category, I'd like to call up Mr. Navroz Contractor, renowned cinematographer and photographer. And the nominees are...
Dada and Partners for NIIT Dining Hall Extension. Nachiket and Jayu Patwardhan for Golden Jubilee Museum. Indigo Architects for Living and Learning Design Center, Padhar Kuch. Amit Khanna Design Associates for Automated Warehousing Facility.
And the award to Indigo Architects.
I think for all architects, being contextual and being relevant to where you build is one of the biggest challenges, and I think if it's done well, we can address a lot of issues that generic architecture and the international monoculture we see here can be challenged. Thank you.
And for the climate zone hot and dry, with special jury commendation goes to Nachiket and J.U. Patwardhan.
I just want to say something about Jayu Patwardhan and Chinu, who is also here, that besides being such fantastic architects, they are also world-renowned filmmakers. And they've made many films which have won all kinds of awards, and I've been privileged to shoot them. So I'm really proud that I'm giving this award to Jayu.
Thank you very much.
To announce the award for environmental design, climate zone warm and humid, can I please call Miss Arundhati Nag, national award winning actor and theatre personality. And the nominees are...
Warmakers for Residence for Mrs. and Mr. Kurian Phillip. Shilpa and Pinky Shah Architects for Collage House. White Dance Studio, Fabian Osner for A House in Oregon.
And the winner is Shilpa and Pinky Shah Architects.
Climate was one of the things which we had attended in this particular project, which we do for all projects, but then there was a lot of other things which we have done. like recycling the materials, the spaces, and a lot of other things.
Thank you so much. Congratulations.
For a cool climate, cool design is a hot favorite to announce the winner of the Environmental Design Climate Zone Temperate. May we please invite Mr. Anirban Mukuti, Marketing Head, Cisco LED, as well as Fashion Guru Prasad Vidappa.
And the nominees are
Maya Praxis for Low Energy Studio Home. Shirish Berry and Associates for Laya, a sustainable alternative urban residence. Manasaram Architects for Bamboo Symphony. Biome for Yellow Train School.
And the winner is Yellow Tree School, which is absolutely cool. It is Biome, ladies and gentlemen.
So I just want to talk about the school because it has a name called Yellow Train. So it's based on Waldorf principles and on Toto Chan's account, a Japanese girl, school girl's account of her school, which was in three bogies of a train. And the client or the promoters were very fond of this story, and the school is based on that, though it's not exactly a train. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. There's a special jury commendation in the Environmental Design Climatic Zone Temperate category, and that goes to Shirish Berry and Associates.
The house is constructed by the materials which is discarded by the society. All the materials are used like that, and not a single material is purchased. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Now, the most precious gift we all share as Indians is our heritage. It's priceless, unique, and irreplaceable. And so those who help preserve this heritage through adaptation or through reuse deserve our appreciation.
To announce the winner for this award, Heritage Architecture Design category, could I please call on stage Mr. Ranjit Singh from British Paints and Pramiti Madhavji, Editor-in-Chief, El Decor India. Let's have a look at the nominees for Heritage Architecture Design of the Year.
Architecture plus value for Berry Chetiyar House. Design Consortium for National Library. Modi Srivastav and Associates for Men's Footwear Showroom. Spaces Architects at Kya for Haveli Dharampura Heritage Hotel. Footprints Earth for Somnath Chhatralaya.
We have two special jury commendations for the Heritage Architecture Design of the Year, and in no particular order, we call on stage first Footprints Earth.
We are very glad not only to restore the building, but this building actually takes care of the underprivileged girls who Gandhi promoted, that they'll go to these villages, turn as a teacher, and therefore they will continue this cycle of education. So thank you for this appreciation.
That's wonderful. Also winning for the Heritage Architecture Design Special Jury Commendation, Spaces Architects at KA. Give us a sense of what this project was all about.
Actually, it took a lot of hard work to restore an haveli and to set an example for adaptive reuse for Chandni Chowk.
Thank you so much for your words. Congratulations.
Interiors are so crucial to our experience of any building. After all structures are meant to be used and not just looked at. Our next category is the Interior Award for Hospitality. Navy, please welcome on stage Mr. Nishant Grover, Chief Operating Officer, Groha Asia Pacific, to give away this award.
The nominees for the Interior Award Hospitality are
Krushad Shroff Architecture and Design for La Folie Palladium. Dhruv Gupta for Sublime. Kumar Lanoche for 24 at 43 Cafe. Fusla Associates for Loft 38.
And the winner for the Interior Award Hospitality is Rushad Shroff, Architecture and Design.
The site was quite a challenge. It was quite a small site. It was almost a pizza slice. So as soon as someone got into the space, they almost had to step out. So in this case, I would really like to thank the client for really indulging me. It was really something that we went beyond just the practicality of a small space. So thank you.
Now, all of us like to engage in a little retail therapy from time to time, whether it is to cure the blues or simply because we're getting tired of our boring blue jeans.
It must be the blues, it can't be the jeans.
Vikram, get your line.
Oh, my line actually is... I don't like my line. It just says I just like having 30-40 different frames to choose from. What does this mean, just because I wear specs?
Okay, let's get on the winner now. To announce the winner, may we please have Ms. Vinita Bali, Chair for Global Alliance for Improved Nutrition, to join us on stage. And let's have the nominees for Interior Award Retail.
Sphurna Designs for Hammer Anvil Stirrup Studio. Oculus, the Building Laboratory for Ragam Showroom. Studio Tab for Balaji Silks. Ravish Mehra Deepak Kalra for Heritage.
And the winner is, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Sphurna Design.
I'd like to call upon my friends over here, my consultant friend Mr. Khushro Jilla from Mumbai and Ankur Gowani. A very small home theatre project that we had, and local fire bricks which are very much made in Rajkot, we chose them. Beautiful learning from my friend Mr. Khushro Jilla from Mumbai, and he's a sound consultant, and he said that the temples of South India, to bring about a kind of a voice or sound to reach to the audience, had a particular kind of geometry, and there these learnings were put into this home theater, and we have done a acoustic-proof less sound theater room, which is equally good for viewing as well as listening, which is so very difficult to contain 1000 wattage of a sound in a 24 by 17 feet room. I say hats off to him, craftsmanship and what not. I think I would invite you all to really look at that particular place, and thank you for recognizing and the TV Grohe and the fraternity. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Our next award is the one that we give to the center of all our universes, that one safe haven from the madness of the world and oasis amongst the dreary deserts of strife.
A home is a sanctuary from all the problems of the universe. It's a place to rest, to recharge, and to enjoy the company of those we love.
Let me invite on stage Ms. Renu Misra, Managing Director, Groha India, to join us on stage.
And the jury commendation for Interior Award House goes to Architecture Breer. And since we have Renu here with us, it's a great time for us to pick her brains. I'd like to request Manisha Natarajan to join us on stage once again for a brief chat with her.
Renu, so the journey has been exciting, just interesting, or full of many ups and downs?
I think I have one word. Wow.
Wow, okay.
So I think, I mean, if wow is way to the world, I think if that was the full form, I would say that we want to take Grohe NDTV Awards to that level. So I think I'm truly excited that we moved from 800 to 1500 entries. I mean, close to 1500 this year. So we're almost there in 3 years.
In terms of the vision, I mean, other than the number, what else can we do? The convergence of design, architecture, India, all of this coming together for probably the world to sit up, see and notice, right?
Yeah, so I think convergence has, you know, I mean, if I have to talk about Grohe, so we say that design, quality and innovation is the convergence. So if I had to put this in context, then Grohe, NDTV and the designers is the convergence. So I would say that this is the best platform that we can offer to a fraternity who've been, you know, who've been a very big spokesperson for us. So this is what we want to, you know, give back to the fraternity who does so much. And it's becoming a big platform. So I think both of us can revel in that yes, we've worked hard and we've got it to this level.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Renu Misra, the entire team of Grohe and NDTV, people who work tirelessly at the background to make this possible.
Hotels and glitzy malls are where we'd like to spend all our days. Let's face it, most of us spend more time at one particular place than any other.
The bar.
Vikram, honesty is certainly a virtue, but I was talking about another structure, the office.
Oh, the office. Nice to go there every 6 months or so. I don't go to office.
Well, for most of us, we spend the majority of our time in our offices, whether it's for meetings or to rub shoulders with our colleagues. A well-designed office can make work a pleasure, and a bad one can really be a pain.
So let me take away your pain. Let's announce the winner for the Interior Award Office. I'd like to call up Mr. Jeffrey Nagpal, Managing Director, EPCO Private Limited. And the nominees are...
Praxis Inc. for Wildcraft Headquarters. Patch Design Studio for Pocket Aces Office. Between Spaces for Between Spaces Office. New Designer Web Private Limited for Turbo India Private Limited.
And the winner for Interior Award Office is Between Spaces.
We have been very intuitive and very exploratory in our practice so far. And we took this opportunity to express that through this work, and was really, in a very short while, in a very low budget, we really tried something. And we kept the design of the space, office space, very simple and open, primarily focusing on how the, you know, the team will really enjoy working there. So that was the prime concern.
That calls for a big round of applause for Between Spaces. Many congratulations.
And let me call on Peter back on stage to get Mr. Nagpal's thoughts on tonight's awards.
As a business journalist, I'm always curious to know, Prime Minister talks about Make in India. You have three manufacturing units actually in North Mumbai. Do you think that is the goal of actually making some of the best interior products in India and exporting it globally is a feasible one, sir?
See, we're in a happy situation where the office volumes are very high in India. So with our own tool rooms, design and manufacturing, we can cater to regular changes in design, amortizing tooling and changing things and keeping with the times.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Our next award is in the memory of one of the greatest architects of India, Mr. Charles Currier, who is no longer with us, but he has left behind a legacy for all of us forever. Got one award this year for the future generation, the Charles Currier Memorial Scholarship and Ethos and D&M Building Product Initiative. I'd like to call upon stage Mr. Geetesh Agarwal, Chief Marketing Officer of D&M India, and Ms. Geeta Balakrishnan from Ethos. Ethos has been with us for again 3 years, and so has D&M. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I think we're waiting to hear the names. So very quickly, let me announce the recipients of this scholarship. Sandeep Kale from VIT's BVB College of Architecture, Pune, and Shubhajit Bagchi from Om Dayal College of Engineering and Architecture, Ulupi area, West Bengal. That's Sandeep, ladies and gentlemen, a big round of applause. Well deserving. And now, Om Dayal College of Engineering, we have Shubhajit Bakchi. Well-deserving students for the Charles Currier Scholarship, and what better way to honor the memory of one of India's greatest architects. A very quick word, this was, you know, DNM's idea, and how do you feel, deserving candidates and getting a scholarship?
Well, someone encouraged DNM 10 years ago, and DNM wants to do the same thing, so it's just an intention to encourage.
Okay. Geeta, tough job shortlisting.
Yes, it was. It was. We had about 100 entries, from which these two turned out to be the winners. What was interesting was, from what he said, the project bridge under which these awards come in is also like a paid forward concept. So these two youngsters, hopefully when you are in a position of prominence, would help a few more youngsters. That's the idea of this.
Congratulations once again.
Thank you.
Well deserved.